The competitions at many venues in these 1992 Winter Games are winding down, and Les Saisies, site of cross country and biathlon, is no different. Hello, everyone. I'm Brian Drever. In fact, today's 20-kilometer individual biathlon for men is the final event here at this venue, and it is also the last chance for the vaunted unified team to save face. They came into these Winter Games favored to sweep the lion's share of medals in biathlon competition. Thus far, the men's team has but a single silver medal to show for its effort. A total of 20 kilometers of cross-country skiing. They can use the freestyle or skating. There are five different laps, in between which they shoot twice each from the prone or lying down position, twice standing up. Yevgeny Redkin of the unified team. This is the only event that he will ski for the former Soviet Union. He is a bit of an unknown quantity. His only result was a 15th place in World Cup. He was just named to the team, and no one knows much about this young unified team member. A very difficult sport, requiring the effort of cross-country skiing and then holding one's breath in order to shoot. Redkin is shooting marvelously. Four out of five targets. They get eight shots to hit five targets. He needed but five. He has cleaned the first round and heads out onto the course well ahead of the time of the current leader, Bailly Sainz of France. Mark Kirchner, a former East German, has won two gold medals in the competition already. He is shooting prone, while ahead of him, number 14, who started earlier, is already in the standing position. That is Mannelqvist of Sweden. These athletes go out one at a time against the clock, and Kirchner cleans around. He heads out, and at this point, he too is well ahead of the current leader's time. That is Zingerl of Italy, another one of the outstanding competitors in this competition. Kirchner also a double gold medalist in the 1991 World Championships. Yevgeny Redkin coming in to finish. You see all the zeros on the right mean that he is perfect on the rifle range, and he is nearly 3 minutes ahead of the time of the current leader. Michael Dixon of Great Britain skating into the finish. His time good for second at the moment, and he is exhausted, has put in a terrific effort. This would be an outstanding result for the young Englishman. Michael Lofgren, the 22-year-old Swede, missed a target in the standing position, had to ski a penalty lap. Here he's shooting in prone and cleans this round, gets out onto the course. Lofgren has already won two bronze medals in these 1992 Winter Games. Here's the time of Kirchner, currently in third spot. And here is the German. He has had two penalty laps to ski, missing a target standing, another one from the third shooting leg in the prone position. Here he is standing and aiming for those targets. They are but 4.5 inches in diameter. They are 50 meters, 164 feet away. Try running up a flight of stairs and then trying to hit a target at this range. You'll get an idea of what biathlon is all about. He misses a target and has to ski a penalty lap again. Kirchner having his difficulties on the rifle range, although he is skiing extremely well. Lofgren coming in to finish. His time good enough for third place at the moment. Two penalty laps, both from the standing positions. The crowd here in Les Saisies getting its last look at biathlon competition. Josh Thompson of the United States, a three-time Olympian, earned a silver medal in the World Championships in 87, and the faithful are watching him put up the eighth best time at the moment. Josh Thompson of the United States coming in to finish. The gold medal performance, however, goes to Yevgeny Redkin of the unified team. This 21-year-old Russian has made good on a single performance in the 1992 Winter Games, earning a gold medal. The silver going to Mark Kirchner of Germany, his third of these Winter Olympics. Michael Lofgren of Sweden takes the bronze. Josh Thompson leads the United States effort with a 14th place finish.